Mellow Joe with me. It's meat announcer Dwayne. First of all, let me give you a fact. Nashville came into the tournament with the number 5 seed. Tomorrow, they are playing to defend that number 5 seed, the fifth place game. The only question is who it is they'll be playing against. It will be either the number 9 seed, who has been overperforming since the moment they came to this tournament. The Tallahassee Roller Girls put up a big fight against Omaha the very first game of the tournament. Went on to get beat by Texas. What do you expect? And then they went on to play against Houston. Houston, where they totally overperformed. That was this morning. No Coast, on the other hand, playing great. Almost took down Kansas City.
Yeah, that was a nail biter. I mean, I think they performed much better than expected. And to the loser of today's bout, of this bout here, will place no lower than 8th. But
right.
Could place as high as 5th if they win.
A 5th place run by Tallahassee, who has never been to the postseason, WFTDA postseason ever before, would be phenomenal. But if No Coast wins this and they go to play the 5th place game, not bad either, because they came in seeded 7th. That would mean that they'll definitely go up a seed.
Right.
Because the lowest that they could go is 6th if they win this game. But they got to go through Tallahassee first. Tallahassee has been playing a phenomenal tournament.
Yeah, it's been a great weekend. Tallahassee, heading into the playoffs here, were 11-4 in sanctioned play in the regular season, and 7-2 in the region. No Coast also similar, 7-2 in the region, 13-4 in sanctioned play. So it's two very evenly matched teams. Although
that's a lot of games in one season.
Yeah, it is
17 games in one season. That's plenty.
That's why Tallahassee is here. They played so many. Tough opponents.
It's put in their work.
Yeah, they have definitely earned their spot here.
Action is about to get underway. Let's give you some lineups first. We'll talk about the officiating crew. IC Chaotic, the head ref for the contest. Umpire Strikes Back, the inside pack ref. Machete Holiday and Major Wood, the jammer refs. The outside pack refs, Whistler, Varner, Von Bombed, and Code Adam, and Ejectulator, our announcer liaison. Action underway. The first jammer for No Coast, Flash Gloria, and she makes it through fast. She picks up lead jammer, immediately puts 4 points on the board, shuts it down, 4 and out No Coast, and that's how we begin.
Off to a great start here. And it looks like Slam Anderson's going to take the jammer line for the Mad Maxines. That's No Coast in the black that you see there. Tallahassee in orange. Stone Herr is jamming, number 420 for Tallahassee.
Stone Herr has put a lot of points on the board in this tournament over the weekend. But, of course, so is Slam Anderson. Both of them looking for the front of this pack. Looks like Stone Herr going to get through first. Lead jammer, Tallahassee. And, in fact, Slam Anderson still hung up. Now she makes her way out. So Stone Herr going to be limited to one scoring run in all likelihood. And she's about to get it underway right now. No Coast has moved all their blockers to the front of the pack.
And she calls it there in turn 2. Did she pick up all 4? Yes, she did. 4 points for Tallahassee. We've got a tie game.
2 jams so far. 4 and out No Coast, followed by 4 and out Tallahassee. Let's talk about the lineups. Playing for Tallahassee, number 11, Pixie Pounder, Femme Venomous, number 28, Trailer Thrash, number 2W, La Voodoo with the number 32. Number 38 is the powerhouse defender, Aaron Brakovich. Sox Populi, number 4. Great Wall of Gina is number 4,000. 420, Stone Herr, that you just saw on the line. Wargasm, number 44. Low Mame, who scored an incredible amount of points this morning. Number 499, Nikki Naylor, 517, Antivirus. The Bombastic Ketchup, and Brat Nicole. But back on the track, No Coast has sent out Flash Gloria again. She immediately picks up lead jammer. Low Mame, the jammer for Tallahassee, is also out, but Flash Gloria gets there and puts 4 more points on the board and calls it off.
No
so
Coast.
We've seen 3 4 and out jams in
yeah,
a row.
Yeah, No Coast doubles their score in a single jam. Quickly running through the No Coast lineup, 00, Kelly Ripanipoloff, number 13, Misanthropy, number 19, Michelle Slugger, number 32, Flash Gloria, number 34, Slam Anderson, number 37, Brooklyn Hearts, number 402, Thicker Than a Snicker, number 45, Sylvia Bullet, number 505, Cobra Kai, number 699, Champagne, number 726, Dropkick Muffy, number 82, Buffy McSkater, number 9, Evil of Speed, and number 94, Luna Bomber.
Ketchup, the jammer for Tallahassee, who scored all the points this morning versus Houston, is who they send out this time, but it is Evil of Speed, the jammer for No Coast, who comes out the front of the pack first. Lead jammer, No Coast.
Evil of Speed was very effective in the game against Kansas City yesterday.
Yes, she was. Evil of Speed trying to break into the back door. Ketchup has exited the front of the pack, so she won't get a grand slam, but she does get a four-point pass and shuts it down. So four jams now where we've seen, five jams.
Five jams, yeah.
That have been all four and out for one team or the other. No Coast, 12 points, four for Tallahassee. And four, right?
We're four jams in, I think.
Four jams in. 12-4, No Coast on top. And 26:02 remaining.
Stone her, but it's Flash Gloria quickly makes her way through the pack first, and she is your lead jammer.
However, Stone her out of the pack as well. Flash Gloria closes it in, finds an open lane on the outside. Only one defender stands in her way. That's number 38. Excuse me, number 32, La Voodoo. She makes it around her. Four more points for No Coast. It's going to make it 20-4. 25:33 left in the first half.
And we've got a whistle. Is that an official timeout? I think they may be just conjecture here, but possibly correcting the scoreboard in-house.
I think so, too, because earlier when we were talking about it, my confusion was in that I was pretty positive every jam was a four and out.
Right, and I think there may have been four, possibly. Well, we'll see here.
We'll see the official word. Yep.
I don't want to get ahead of myself. See the hard-working refs there on your screen.
It's easier to be wrong less the less you speculate. Just in life.
Good life advice from yep. Denouncer Dwayne.
Yeah. That's about all I got. Slam Anderson standing on the line now for No Coast. Once the action resumes, take a look there. There's a Brooke and Hearts fan. Brooke and Hearts, the blocker from the home team, No Coast Derby Girls.
No Coast has a very loud cheering section here in-house. I don't know how well you can hear them at home, but we can hear them pretty well here from our vantage point.
Yeah, not a bad crowd, actually, filling up the Pershing Center. Of course, the No Coast Derby Girls have been very popular since their beginnings in 2006, I want to say, late 2006. Hello,
here we go.
Hop Yard.
We've got the signs here.
I know that Hop Yard appreciates that, I'm sure.
And we are back in the action here.
Double H on the sidelines has an explanation as to that official timeout, and we'll hear it right after this jam. Slam Anderson, the lead jammer for No Coast, en route to the backfield to put some points on the board. Low Mame out of the pack as well, and that's going to keep Slam Anderson to 1-4 and out. Double H, what'd you find out?
All right, well, Great Wall of Gina for Tallahassee was sent off for a major penalty. She was in the queue because the box was full, and the jam after that, she was not placed on the track, thus she did not serve her penalty. She was given that penalty of 1 minute plus an additional 1 minute insubordination. So Great Wall of Gina in the box for 2 minutes.
All right, Great Wall of Gina out of action for two straight minutes, and
wow.
As Mella Jo and I assured you, nothing to do with the scoreboard at all.
Nope.
Pretty sure that's what we said. Action back underway. Flash Gloria once again facing off against.
Nice.
Oh,
nice
man, Flash Gloria.
There.
Slices in there. Antivirus was the jammer for Tallahassee.
Yeah, look at that smile on her face. Well deserved.
She's happy about it, and Flash Gloria has been a staple of the No Coast Derby Girls scoring core for many years now.
Some of the other skaters for other leagues, I've noticed they're cheering her on in the stands. Several skaters have picked her on their fantasy leagues, cheering her on as she's helping out all the fantasy derby players as well.
Evil of Speed.
Nice move on the inside. Threads the needle, and she's the lead jammer.
Yeah, nice work. She found an open lane and just took it to the bank, didn't she?
Nice work. Stone Her going to the box for a track cut. She's going to be in there for a minute and...
Forearm major.
Oh, that was a forearm major. Excuse me.
I could see from this angle, why you'd think it. Evil of Speed jamming on a post. Closes in on it, but man, she was just flattened by Aaron Breakabitch, the bomber from Tallahassee. And Evil of Speed scrambles back to her feet, makes it up the gut, and a 5-point grand slam for the jammer from No Coast.
Tallahassee severely outnumbered right now.
No Coast looking at this pack, squeezes their way through, and another 5-point grand slam. No Coast hitting the books, 44-4. They got a 40-point lead. And 22 and a half minutes left. The jam's not over. Evil of Speed going in again.
And she does it again. That's another five in the sky and a grand slam for No Coast Derby Girls.
Tell you what, it is hard to keep back a jammer like Evil of Speed when you only have two blockers. Now they get another one back. The cavalry has arrived. And the power jam comes to an end as Stone Her rejoins the action.
Stone Her. On the back straightaway, on the outside, didn't pick up any. She feels like it was two, judging by the hand gesture.
Yeah, she insisted she had two. Major Wood, the pack ref, the jammer ref assigned to her, disagrees. He says zero.
Yeah, he's certainly got a much better vantage point from the center than we do here. Certainly glad I don't have to make that call.
Yeah, no, sir. I enjoy this one much better. No Coast, no mercy is the message from that gentleman. No Coast fan, local, very strong fan base, strong support is what they get here, as we mentioned before. Timeout call by Tallahassee. They want to talk about this. They have a 45-point deficit after 8 minutes. And the way Tallahassee has been playing up till now, you would really expect them to be a little more in this game.
Yeah, I think maybe they've taken a timeout here to try and take a second just to breathe. Sometimes that helps so much when you can just take a second, take a deep breath, count to 10, and say, okay, we got the jitters out now. Let's get down to brass tacks, get to business here.
Yep, get through it.
So we'll see if they're making any adjustments in strategy here, if the timeout helps. Low Mame now taking the jammer line for Tallahassee. And we've got Flash Gloria for the Mad Maxines. If you're just joining us, No Coast in black, Tallahassee in orange.
If you want to talk to us, tweet using the hashtag talk2WFTDA. That's the numeral 2. Low Mame makes her way out the front of the pack, but...
Oh.
She does so with a cut track major, and Flash Gloria, the jammer for No Coast, is in a power jam. Catches up to the track for her first scoring run, 5 points on the board. And she's going back for more.
Yeah, there is no sign of slowing her down right now. As she approaches the back of the pack on the outside, jukes to the inside on the back straightaway, and that's 5 more points. For Flash Gloria, No Coast looking pretty good right now.
Prior to this jam, Tallahassee took a timeout to get their heads together and make some adjustments, go back in. This is not what they had in mind, I guarantee.
No, this was not in the playbook. As Gloria picks up 5 more. Rounds the track quickly again at the back of the pack. A little bit of resistance this time. But it's still not enough to stop her. Another grand slam for No Coast Derby Girls. Mad Maxines are on fire right now. This power jam is costly for Tallahassee.
Flash Gloria going in for another one on the inside, nearly untouched. Wargasm gets a chunk of her as she exits the front of the pack, but she's stays on target anyway, puts five more points on the board. Now she's going for another one, but the power jam is over. Lomain back on the track, and I don't think Flash Gorian knows it. Yeah, she did. She called it off just in time.
Just in the nick of time. Man, that was close.
Yes, it was. Lomain had her foot in the door at least.
Wow. Yeah, definitely forced that one.
Yeah, no doubt about it. Talk to us on Talk to WFTDA as Emily did. She informed us we saw that sign that said Hello Hop Yard earlier.
Uh-huh.
Turns out the Hop Yard is a local establishment in Tallahassee where they're having a watch party right now.
Oh, nice. Well, hello to everyone at the Hop Yard. Thanks for joining us here on WFTDA.TV. We really appreciate it. It's great.
Yeah. Glad to have you with us, Hop Yard. Tell you what, give a big cheer for your Tallahassee. And you know what? Why don't you do this. Take a picture of the crowd at the Hop Yard and tweet that, will you? Somebody's got the capability on their phone. Let's have a picture of it. We'd like to see it.
Pictures or it didn't happen.
That's right. That's right. Picture it didn't happen. I know you and Tallahassee have to be proud of your team up to this point. They're having a hard time in this contest so far, but
yeah, just to be here though is pretty awesome,
and it's only 10 minutes into the game.
Right? Yeah, we've got a lot of derby ahead of us. Slam Anderson out of the pack first. She's the lead jammer for No Coast, but hot on her heels is
Ketchup,
trying to do just that right now. Going to keep the pressure on. Going to try and force her to call it.
3-2 pack advantage for No Coast. And, yeah, actually, she does force her to call it. No points for anybody. 19-23 in the first half is what remains. 78-4, No Coast over Tallahassee. And Stone Hur is who's going to go in next for Tallahassee. Yeah. Flash Gloria, number 32, going to represent No Coast, as she so often does. In fact, Flash Gloria has already put 45 points on the board. 45 points by herself.
She's doing an incredible job here.
But you really got to give it up for this No Coast defense. They've held Tallahassee to 4 points so far after 11 jams.
Yeah, I think especially with new fans, the blockers are often underestimated. As that, you know, the jammers are literally the stars.
To the jammer goes the glamour, as they say. Flash Gloria out the front of the pack. And lead jammer once again goes to No Coast. Stone Hur is out as well. Flash Gloria. Absolutely untouched, nearly unnoticed on the inside. 4 points on the board, four and out once again. We've actually had a lot of jams. We're getting ready for our 12th jam in the 12th minute in the game because it's been a lot of four and out.
Yeah, a lot of four and out on this one. We'd like to take a quick moment to thank Rydell, the official skate of the WFTDA. Unmatched quality, unmatched performance, Rydell. You can check them out online, rydellskates.com.
Evil of Speed. The tall jammer for No Coast stands on the line once again, but this time she's not going to get lead jammer. Instead, it is Stone Hur. No, excuse me. Lomain is the jammer for Tallahassee. Picks up lead jammer en route to the backfield. There's only two blockers for her to get through. She does it. She falls forward. She calls the jam.
Oh,
from
she
the prone position in midair, and
she was able to pick up four there.
Yeah, that was close. But she picked up four, and she shuts it down before the jammer from No Coast gets there. So forward momentum by Tallahassee, 82-8, however. 17:15 left in the first half. Flash Gloria goes to the line now for the Mad Maxines, which is the name of the No Coast travel team.
And Tallahassee, also known as Capital Punishment in the orange, putting ketchup on the line. The skater, not the condiment,
right,
for those on the audio stream.
Flash Gloria, MVP 2 years ago at the Amber Waves of Pain tournament.
You can certainly see why with this. Whoa, nice apex jump on turn three. Picks up 4 points, but she allowed three also. But it was still fun to watch.
What an important part of this squad Flash Gloria is. Look at that.
The apex jump is the slam dunk of our sport.
Yeah, it really is. That's right.
Just love to see that. Not everyone can pull that off.
Yep, agreed.
But the ones who do, oh, it's beautiful.
It's worth the same amount of points. but there's just something special about it.
It is. It really is. Stonehurst now on the line for capital punishment. And we've got Slam Anderson back for No Coast. And it's Slam Anderson out of turn one. She's the lead jammer.
No Coast wreaking havoc out there. But once again, it's going to be a four and out because Stonehurst, the jammer for Tallahassee, is out as well. Slam Anderson enters the pack. She exits the pack. She calls the jam, four and out once again. 90-11, No Coast over Tallahassee, 15 and a half minutes left.
Yeah, if you're a skater listening or watching at home and you're tired of slipping through slippery corners, try the new Radar Villain Wheel. You can check it out online, radarwheels.com.
Yeah, I have heard nothing but overwhelmingly positive about the Radar Villain Wheel.
That is one of the big things talked about today at the Vendor Village here in-house.
Definitely making a huge impression on the skaters.
And Gloria, again, is your lead jammer. Quickly made her way through the pack in turn one. Both jammers, though, on their scoring run. But Gloria has about a 30-foot head start here as she approaches the pack in the back straightaway. To the outside, now to the inside. She picked up three, but a loud four. Tallahassee comes out on top in that pass. Nice work.
Yep, not bad. That's how you do it. That's what they got to start doing now and cannot stop for the remaining 45 minutes contest.
They can try and nickel and dime their way back into this, but it's going to take...
It's going to take that, and it's going to take some power jams, and we haven't seen hardly... Actually, we haven't seen any jammer penalties, have we? I don't think there's been a power jam yet. Has there? Maybe one?
Yeah, we've been light on them for sure. And both the jammers out of the pack, No Coast with a little bit of an edge here. A catch-up now passes the No Coast jammer. That's Evil of Speed. Evil of Speed calls it. And we're going to get some fresh skates out here. That didn't take very long.
Nope. That's what we... You know, there you go. This is loving jam
this
17, and we're 16 minutes in.
Wow. We're averaging almost the jam a minute.
Pretty much, yeah.
That's a lot of derby action.
That it is, and it's a lot of four and outs, and most of them are by No Coast. 93-15 is the current score. No Coast sends out Flash Gloria, who has already put 56 points on the board in this contest. Flash Gloria up the middle. Stonehurst plays some defense on her as the two of them get in. Man, Stonehurst with a huge hit, and she sails through the pack, but she sails through the pack straight to the box. Power jam, Flash Gloria, and No Coast.
I missed the penalty on that, but she is most definitely in the box, and we've got a power jam in favor of No Coast. No Coast has been very effective in these power jam situations all weekend long. And that's five in the sky and a grand slam for Flash Gloria. No Coast adding five more. Going to try and do it again as she approaches the back of the pack and makes her way through. And another five in the sky, grand slam. And make it five more. Flash Gloria running up the score here again as No Coast breaks 100 in this jam.
Man, only halfway through the first half or a quarter of the way through the game. Flash Gloria approaches the back of the pack for another scoring run, and she gets another grand slam. These are what some might call natural grand slams. Stonehurst was hung up in the pack the entire time. Now she's broken through. So Flash Gloria is not going to get another one. She shuts it down, 118-15, under 12 minutes left before halftime.
And it looks like Slam Anderson's going to be jamming this one for No Coast. And Lomain in orange for Tallahassee jamming.
Looks like, I see the defender from Tallahassee realized at the last second she was wearing a pivot cover, and so was their blocker in the box. So off the track, she tossed it. Meanwhile, Slam Anderson, the jammer for No Coast, through and lead jammer. And in the time it took me to say it, en route to the backfield, there's a three wall of orange. She busts right through it, 4 points on the board, and she shuts it down. Womain still a mile away when she did.
Both of these teams are using a pretty light jammer rotation here, too. We're seeing a lot of the same skaters out, and we may see that play a bigger role in the second half.
Mm-hmm.
It's certainly not going to phase Flash Gloria. I don't think we have to worry about her getting too tired because she's a machine.
Yeah, it seems to be.
That's right.
This time it's Eva LaSpeed for No Coast. And catch up.
Wow, and Eva LaSpeed just sailed over to the inside of the track and then back to the outside, right through everybody, and picked up lead jammer. Catch up made her way through the pack as well. Eva LaSpeed makes her way through. She did not see catch up. Catch up comes with her and answers all 4 points. It's a wash.
Nice.
Boy, Ketchup was sneaky.
Nice move. Yeah, Tallahassee's doing a real good job at finding those holes in the defense and just skating right through it. You give them an inch, they'll take a mile.
Normally, Ketchup comes out slow, but not in this game. Ha-ha.
Thank you.
To the world for that.
We'll be here all weekend.
Flash Gloria on the line, facing off against Stoner. Don't her, eyes set on the backfield, looking for an opening. It's a pretty watertight pack. She finds the front of the pack. Sylvia Bullitt, the longtime veteran, actually one of the original No Coast Derby girls, is the last defender who stands in her way. Oh, man! And Flash Gloria came up to play some defense on her, too. And that was a shoulder check, evidently, but it was not pretty.
And we've got both of the jammers on their scoring run. She quickly calls it. Not sure. No, no one picked up any points on that one. No points for anyone. That was exciting. I like the jammer on jammer action there in the front straightaway as well.
Flash Gloria was not kidding. Came out swinging.
She means business.
Yep.
Slam Anderson on the jammer line for No Coast. And she's going up against Ketchup.
Got three blockers on the field for Tallahassee, only two for No Coast. Tallahassee wants to get it going. Clock's not their friend, obviously, and they enjoy the defensive advantage. So they take a knee and get this thing started. But it doesn't serve them very well because the jammer for No Coast is the first one through. Slam Anderson, once again, lead jammer if you're listening to this thing.
And here comes Ketchup. Made it through the pack cleanly, able to call it off. So it's another 0-0 jam.
If you're listening to this thing, you really ought to upgrade to our fine, high-quality feed. It has looked great all weekend. That's what I've been told. We're on the end where we can't see it. But if for those of you who are watching it, you should know that No Coast is wearing all black, and Tallahassee is in their signature iconic orange color.
I'm loving the lighting here. For those just listening to the audio stream, you're really missing out on the way the track is lit up is just incredible. I'm loving this.
This is a great old derby venue. It's pretty underrated. It's not as flashy and well known as you know some of them, the Craneway and the Roy Wilkins, but sure serves its purpose.
Yeah, I am loving this venue. Been an excellent weekend so far here in Lincoln, Nebraska.
Womain, the jammer for Tallahassee, picks up lead jammer, makes it to the pack, puts 4 points on the board and shuts it down. So a four and out by Tallahassee. 130-23, 7 minutes in the first half. Not bad at all.
Stoneher going to jam this one out for Tallahassee up against Flash Gloria. Flash Gloria with 85 points so far in this bout.
Yeah, Flash Gloria just a machine tonight. Eva LaSpeed is the next closest jammer in the game to her, and she's put up 33 of her own. Eva LaSpeed, the second most successful jammer tonight for No Coast, has outscored at Tallahassee by 10 points thus far.
Wow.
Flash Gloria is who they send out again. Stonehurst, it is a 4-2 defensive advantage in favor of No Coast. 130-23, No Coast. 6 minutes left in the first half. Oh, it looks like there's the Pack getting a slow start, and that actually burns up the penalty clock of La Voodoo, the blocker for Tallahassee, so they get her back. The more time that goes by, the more blockers Tallahassee is going to get back. And now they get their fourth. Now all the blockers are out on the track, but none of them are doing anything. Pixie Pounder, Venomous, La Voodoo, and that's Aaron Breakabitch on the inside. Those are the blockers for Tallahassee. And then on the No Coast side, you got Kelly Rip-a-Nipple-Off, Thicker Than a Snicker, Sylvia Bullitt, Bully McSkater, with only 48 seconds, a minute and 15 into the jam. Crowd getting a little impatient. You can hear it in the background.
Yeah, they're not the happiest they've been during this bout.
Finally, the last blocker rolls over the pivot line, and the jammers are released. Flash Gloria and Stonehurst plunge into the pack. And Flash Gloria through first, lead jammer, No Coast.
And there goes Stonehurst, also out of the pack. Both jammers now on their scoring run.
Every jam tonight almost, this is what has happened. No Coast gets her jammer through. Tallahassee gets their jammer through. No Coast catches up, four and out. Rinse and repeat the entire first half. And the result is 133-25, No Coast over Tallahassee, 4.5 minutes. Until halftime.
Yeah, and one thing that we've seen a lot of too, Tallahassee squeaked an extra couple points out of that one.
Mm-hmm.
So they
yeah, yeah, right.
They've been pretty good at that. The problem is the power jams is where a lot of the score has come in so far for No Coast.
Mm-hmm. Well, and clearly, when both jammers are on there, the fact that there are so many four and outs means that Tallahassee is getting their jammer
yeah.
out also, but they just can't get her out first. And here we go once again. Slam Anderson for No Coast comes out first. Catch up for Tallahassee is right behind her. Slam Anderson gets to the back of the pack. This time there's a four wall waiting for her on the Tallahassee side. Big orange four wall. And they shut her down. She's got to stop it because catch up catches up. And no points for anybody. It remains 133-25. Just under 4 minutes left till halftime.
We'll take a quick second to thank Union Vacations, providing a trip to the 2013 champs to the winner of the Bracket Bonanza. That's awesome. Gotta love the vacation at stake there. Make sure you fill out your brackets for the championships coming up.
And once again, No Coast gets the lead jammer, number 9, Evil of Speed. And once again, the Tallahassee jammer comes out also, but just not quite as fast. However, here's a twist to the story. Lomain, the jammer for Tallahassee, sent to the box on a forearm minor, which is her fourth. Evil of Speed cleared for takeoff. She puts 5 points on the board. It's a loose pack, which is a jammer's dream sailing conditions. Now another blocker lost.
And we've got a penalty party now.
Yep. Femme Venomous goes to the box, and that's one less blocker for Evil of Speed to deal with. In fact, it's micro pack on both sides. There's only two blockers on either side. La Voodoo and Aaron Breakabitch having to hold down the fort against the power jammer Evil of Speed on their own.
And our pivot here picking up a fourth minor, and she's going to the box. Looks like she will be able to have a seat there.
But she just sits down.
Almost waved
orgasm.
Off on that one.
Yeah. So still only two blockers for Evil of Speed to have to contend with. Nobody standing up in the box.
And that's another five in the sky and a grand slam.
It's going to be like this for a bit. And Evil of Speed loves it. She's going back for another one to the outside. She gets a big hit out of La Voodoo. Has to recycle herself. And now the power jam has come to an end. Lomain rejoins the action.
And she picked up 4 more points on that one.
Yeah, Lomain approaches the back of the pack, and that makes Evil of Speed have to call it. She does put 4 more points on the board first. 161-25, No Coast
wow.
over Tallahassee. Minute and a half left in the first half of the final game of day two of the Landlocked Lace Up, the 2012 WFTDA South Central Region Playoffs. You're watching exclusive coverage of it on WFTDA.tv.
Thank you so much for joining us. If you're just now joining us, it's Tallahassee in orange, and we've got No Coast in black.
No Coast with a huge lead out here. They came out swinging and haven't stopped. We did have 26 jams. This is the 26th jam in the half. We're under 1 minute in the first half now, so this is a good chance that this is it, although as fast as these jams go, we'll see. Stoneher, the first one through. Lead jammer, Tallahassee. And Slam Anderson right behind her. So the reverse of what we have seen a lot in this game. And Slam Anderson gets in front of her, forces her to call off the jam. A few seconds later, and they wouldn't have had enough time to line up again. But
yeah, it looks like we've got enough time for just one more jam here in the first half.
Catch up is who they're going to send out next. Tallahassee is who I mean by they, the big orange team. Catch up sent out to the line for Tallahassee, and number 9, Evil of Speed, once again for No Coast. Evil of Speed hung up in the back of the pack. Catch up is the first one through. Lead jammer Tallahassee, and she's got half a track.
Yeah, this is a nice big lead for Catch up here.
This is more like what Ketchup has wanted this entire time, and a thick four wall of Tallahassee in the front of the pack.
Yeah, very effective right now.
Yeah, Evil of Speed. There's no chance of her getting out. Put down by La Voodoo on the inside, and she falls out of this pack. Oh, and Ketchup makes her way through for 5 points, and then she calls off the jam after only 5 points with the period clock having run out. So that's going to be the halftime score.
Nice little exclamation point there from Tallahassee at the last jam of the first half.
Well, Malajoa, what do you think about this first half? Obviously, both teams doing a good job getting their jammer out of the pack. However, No Coast routinely has done it first.
Yeah.
No Coast jammer comes out, Tallahassee jammer comes out. No Coast jammer enters the pack, puts 4 points on the board, shuts it down before Tallahassee gets there. And then punctuated every 7 jams by a power jam for No Coast, where they put 20 points on the board.
And the power jams more than anything are the contributing factor to the big cushion in the lead for No Coast right now. I mean, just very costly so far, those power jams that have been given up.
Melojo, one half remains for the second day of the tournament. The 2012 South Central WFTDA playoffs. It has been a great time so far. We are so happy to have so many of you watching us on WFTDA.tv, including, if you remember in the first half, somebody tweeted us, which you can do at Talk2WFTDA. Like our friends at the Hop Yard did, one of the beloved establishments in Tallahassee, they took a picture of it. Oh, looks like they actually have it up on the big screen. See
nice.
That? Looks like a projector to me.
Nice.
Not bad, huh?
Hey, yeah.
It's almost like...
Hopefully we won't break it.
You know what? To them, it's probably the same size from their perspective as it is to us up here.
It's like being there.
Yeah.
That's a great idea, you guys.
Yep. And... if you've been watching the entire first half, this is what you've seen. The No Coast Derby girls have put a lot of points on the board, a lot of points. Particularly Flash Gory has put 88 points on the board. Evil of Speed has put 61 of her own. And the way that the majority of them have been done is through quick four and out jams. They get their jammer out. Tallahassee, to their credit, has gotten their jammer out quite a bit as well. But... they get it out second, and then they limit No Coast to only one scoring run, but No Coast gets that scoring run, and it adds up after a while. And then No Coast has had a couple of big monster power jams as well.
Yeah, very very costly power jams for Tallahassee so far. But Tallahassee, Lo Mame has 12 points, and Ketchup with 12 points as well.
And those are the top two jammers on Tallahassee.
Right. Stoneher also has 6 points. And that totals all of Tallahassee's points so far.
Right, that's 30. 12, 12, and 6. But you know, they're still in it. They're going to keep hacking away at this. They got 30 more minutes to chip away at this lead. And they are a very capable team. They are, they're on enemy territory because this is no coast home ground. And they got some enthusiastic fans, but look at this. Here we go. Lo Mame, who scored a lot of points this morning, back on the track. She gets lead jammer. She plunges into the pack. And she puts 5 points on the board.
Nice work. They're starting the second half off right. Tallahassee maybe made some adjustments here at the half.
This is not a power jam. The other jammer was just hung up, so it's a natural kind of jamming that only a talented jammer like Lo Mame can do.
She picked up 4 and allowed 2. Still a net gain there for Tallahassee. Nice work.
And nice work. 9 more unanswered points. 163-39. Hey, how many jams do we have in the first period? Like 26, 27?
Yeah, it was.
Do that 26 more times, huh?
Yeah, right. Catch up now on the line for Tallahassee going up against Slam Anderson for NoCoast.
That's how NoCoast got here. That's exactly how they did it in the first half. But easier said than done. They're going to try, though. Catch up goes out. Slices through the pack. Lead jammer Tallahassee for the second time in a row. And once again, oh, Slam Anderson on a forearm major. Goes to the box.
Here we go. Now they just got to capitalize on this. This is exactly the type of, this is the opposite of the situation we saw a lot in the first half.
Oh, man.
Bust through the two wall, says, let me through. I'm picking up 5 points.
Airborne assault, too. She jumped in the air, busted right through the middle of them. Catch up on a rampage. She got 10 points so far. She's going in for more. Look out, though. She hit the back of the defender from NoCoast. Kelly ripped a nipple off pretty hard. Did not get a back block for it.
But she did get 5 points as she scoots past them here.
That is how it's done. 9 unanswered points in the first jam. 15 so far in this. That's 24 consecutive unanswered points by Tallahassee in the second half. Ketchup taken down as she enters for another scoring run. But she...
We've got a very split pack.
She gets back to her feet and she's through for another one. 20 points so far by Ketchup in the jam. And
Ketchup living up to her name now with the score.
Evidently.
Slam Anderson out of the box and on her scoring run now. Ketchup calls this one.
Ketchup not name, Ketchup job. One more scoring run, and that was, what, 25 points? So plus the 9 from the first jam, that is 34 unanswered points in the second half after 2 jams. I was kidding when I said do that 27 more times, but evidently that's exactly what they have in mind.
It's almost like they can hear you.
Yeah, evidently.
Stone Herr on the jammer line for Tallahassee going up against Evilest Speed. For NoCoast. If you're just joining us in the second half, NoCoast is in black, Tallahassee in orange.
We don't have much in the way of blockers for this jam, only 2 from either side, although they get off to a slow start, and that lets Great Wall of China come out first, and once again, Tallahassee with the lead jammer. She makes it through.
That was a nice move on the outside of turn, or the front straightaway. Didn't even get to turn one, and she was already lead jammer.
En route to the backfield, a tiny, tiny pack. She goes from the outside to the inside, back to the outside. It's like a slalom event. She puts 4 points on the board and shuts it down. 4 and out, taste of their own medicine, huh? 163, suddenly it's only a 100-point lead. I say only a 100-point lead, but hey, compared to what it was at the half, not bad, huh?
Right, right. They're whittling away at that, trying to close that gap by as much as possible here. Flash Gloria is going to be the jammer for NoCoast on this one. Going up against Lo Mame for Tallahassee. And we are underway. This jam is started.
You wouldn't know it. Stationary blockers taking their time coming off the line. This is not in Tallahassee's favor, by the way. Lo Mame, their jammer.
And any time that time is being eaten off the clock and you're behind, it is never in your favor. Time is one of your biggest enemies when you are behind.
Flash Gloria jamming for No Coast. Now she slices it up, right up the middle. Lead jammer, No Coast Derby Girls, Mad Maxines.
Got a very spread out pack here.
No Coast is going to get their first points of the second half. She circumvents the entire defensive line. Three blockers that are on the track and, oh, nice. Flash Gloria, eyes set on the jammer for Tallahassee and waits to call it off until she gets there. And it pays off big time because
she picked up a back block there.
She did.
Right,
she
at the very end.
Back block major at the very last second. And if Flash Gloria hadn't held off on calling the jam, which she was only doing to kill penalty minutes, but or kill clock minutes, but the unexpected happy accident consequence of that is that she also committed a back block major, and now Slam Anderson gets to reap the benefits. She goes out for a power jam in favor of No Coast. And immediately picks up lead jammer. She's going through for another one. A three wall in the back by Tallahassee. Slam Anderson tries to get through it. She's pushed to the outside by number 28, Fem Venomous.
And that's five in the sky and a grand slam for Slam Anderson. That's going to put her at 17 points for the bout so far. Looking to pick up a few more, and that's five more to the score of No Coast. No Coast in a real good spot right now in this power jam.
Going through for another one. All right, so slow start in the second half by No Coast, but now they go to work, but wait a minute, man. Cut track major on Slam Anderson, and the tables have turned. Tallahassee gets her jammer back, and she was just about to come out of the box anyway, which means Slam Anderson is going to be there for a while, almost a full minute. So Lil Mame has some time to work. She pushes her way through that pack.
That's a very solid three wall by No Coast.
Couple of jammers follow her out the front of the pack. They were close to being out of play, but they managed to.
Brooke and Hearts is doing such a great job blocking here in this one.
No doubt about it. Yeah, number 37, Brooke and Hearts, just putting on a cliche. And Low Main going to get around it, goes to the outside, finds an open lane, five-point grand slam. Low Main trying to erase the damage from the No Coast power jam. And look at this, she does it again on the outside.
Twice in a row, you know.
Same trick.
It shouldn't have worked twice, but it sure did. And she's going to go to the inside this time, takes a spill and calls it off.
Calls a jam from the floor, and the jammer from No Coast is awarded 2 points from before she went to the box. That makes it 179-73, just under 22 minutes left in the second day of the tournament. BUI of Jacksonville has been talking to us all day on Twitter by using the hashtag Talk2WFTDA. BUI points out at this point that the NSOs, Team Pink, as BUI calls them, deserve a shout out, and that's true, they do. And we have a talented NSO crew here. We got a great officiating crew all around. Things really run smoothly. Action back underway. Slam Anderson versus Ketchup. Slam Anderson through first. Ketchup gets in front of her, forces her to call it off. No points for anybody. 179-73, 21 minutes left.
And we'd also like to thank the makers of Antic Gumball Toe Stops, Heartless Wheels, Reckless Wheels, and Moto Bearings. Green Monster doesn't just give you great derby products, they give you confidence. You can check them out online, greenmonster.com. That's GRNMNSTR.com.
Stonehurst standing on the line once again, facing off against Eva LaSpeed. Three on three defense. Stonehurst trying to find an opening up the gut, but she does not get it. Eva LaSpeed gets there instead. On the inside, lead jammer, No Coast. Stonehurst makes it out too. Have we seen this before?
I believe we have. Stonehurst going to try and keep the pressure on, force her to call it off or pick up some points of her own here. Very tight pack, and the jam is called. No Coast not picking up any, but Tallahassee sneaks in one.
Good grief. Talking about the hashtag talk to WFTDA, the hashtag use a Sharpie is what WFTDA president and no doubt happy Atlanta roller girl Alas Insane had to say to us, because she pointed out that the sign that we held in the camera a little bit ago was a little bit too small. so we did use a Sharpie, and we have a much bigger sign now. Oh, of course, you know, maybe you can see in the background. we'll get it on the fisheye lens as soon as we have a chance. I guess I didn't think that part through at first.
We need a poster board, I think, from this angle.
That's right. low MAME jamming this time for Tallahassee, facing off against Flash Gloria.
Flash Gloria out of the pack first, though, but she did not make it through cleanly. Blocking out of bounds is going to deny her lead jammer. So it's, oh, we've got no lead jammer.
That's right. Low MAME ineligible as well.
We're going to have a two-minute jam.
I remember such a thing from earlier games besides this one. Low MAME in scoring position, as is Flash Gloria. Flash Gloria makes it there. En route to the backfield. Once again, it's Flash Gloria. Low MAME has completed her first scoring run for 4 points, but Flash Gloria makes a second one. That's 4 points, and perhaps more significantly, that gives her 102 points in the game. She
wow.
herself has crossed the triple digit mark.
Wow, that is incredible. Got to respect that sort of talent.
Yeah, no doubt about it.
Flash Gloria picks up four more. Four more also for Low MAME.
So they're just matching each other on points at this point, which is probably fine with NoCoast because they currently enjoy a lead of 105 points, and there's only 18 minutes left.
Right.
So,
so long as they can
not?
Get their jammer through with each pass, you know, it's not like they've lost any ground, so to speak.
Right. In fact, they've gained the ground on the clock. At this point, a match on points is a gain for NoCoast.
Right. Yeah, this second half does look a lot different when you break down the effectiveness of Tallahassee in the second half versus the first half. They really have kind of stayed on par with NoCoast a lot better in the second half, but NoCoast just got off to such an early lead, it's nearly insurmountable.
Yeah, they really came out hot in the first half.
Ketchup, number 57 for Tallahassee. Stuck in the pack, Slam Anderson on the outside of turn two is your lead jammer. Two wall holding back Ketchup right now.
And to Tallahassee's credit, their jammers have plenty of points. Low MAME pushing 50, and Ketchup has 32 of her own.
Oh, yeah, no.
In any
no
other game, that would be great. But yeah. NoCoast, this is definitely an offensively heavy game.
Yes.
You know, the defense having a really hard time, or more correctly, they're focusing more on opening up lanes and for their own jammers than they really are playing defense on the other jammer, and that goes to both sides. And then a big part of it has been the defensive penalties. There have been a lot of defenders in the box in this game.
Yeah, those power jams are costly. NoCo sitting at 203, Tallahassee 90. We've got about just a little bit over 16 minutes left in this bout. Evil of Speed stuck in the back behind a three wall. Meanwhile, Tallahassee's jammer, Stone Her, out of the pack quickly, almost with a, oh, and look at this, we've got a power jam now. Stone Her on the inside picks up 5 points and a grand slam, much needed grand slam for Tallahassee.
16 minutes left. Tallahassee's gonna need a whole lot of these if they wanna get in this game. Very least, they can make it look a lot better on paper.
Right.
Stone Her plunges into that three wall in the front of the pack. NoCoast has one of their blockers in the back of the pack. Thicker than a snicker, being trapped by the defense of Tallahassee.
Thicker than a snicker, doing some excellent blocking this evening as well.
But she was certainly being goat herded there. And now Tallahassee going to try to put a conga line up so that they can maximize these points on the power jam by Ketchup. They do have four blockers on the NoCo side to contend with. Ketchup fighting that front wall. Having a hard time making it through. And pushed out on the outside. Has to recycle herself, but they're out of play. They got to let her go. So weed jammer Ketchup. But they made her take a lot of time getting it. Now Evil of Speed standing up in the box. So
yeah, they certainly ate a lot of time off of this power jam. Almost neutralized it completely. As Evil of Speed now back on the track. Up against the four wall. Nice solid four wall right now from Tallahassee.
One more five-point pass, and that last jam puts Tallahassee up over the century mark, 203 to 110.
Got a pretty high-scoring bout here this evening.
Big time, big time. Under 14 minutes to go in the game. This is the last game of day two of the tournament, but tomorrow's the big payoff. Tomorrow's the punchline to the joke. We have a contest for every place up the bracket, starting with the ninth place game, after that the seventh, the fifth, and then the two contests that will determine who gets to go to Atlanta or stay in Atlanta, as the case may be. We already know they do. .207 to .110, 13 minutes left.
And we got Slam Anderson taking the jammer line for No Coast. And Stonehur for Tallahassee. Take a quick moment here to let you know about PrintCo for your league's printing and promotional needs. Hit up PrintCoGraphics.com. That's PrintCoGraphics.com.
Every league needs it. You might as well have it. You might as well get it from PrintCo. Stonehur comes off the line, clawing her way through this pack. Only one defender stands in the way. It is thicker than a snicker. Bounces her to the inside. She's got to recycle herself. Good work by Snicker, because Stonehur was cleared for takeoff. And in the confusion, Slam Anderson finds her way out the front of the pack. Lead jammer, No Coast. But you got to give the credit to Thicker, because Stonehur had it. If not for the defender from No Coast, thicker than a snicker. Now, Stonehur makes it out the front of the pack as well. So both jammers in scoring position, but Slam gets there first. Four and out, four and out, four and out. That is the motto of No Coast tonight. And it has been very successful.
It's always effective if you can get that lead jam to just call it when you've got those four. Never a bad strategy. Hey, we'd also like to thank Adam Wheels, a proud partner and official wheel of the WFTDA. Check them out online at adamwheels.com.
There have been a lot of Adam Wheels touching the concrete this weekend, a lot. I would venture there's even more than 118 of them, which is how many points Flash Gloria has scored in this game. 118 points.
Wow, that is impressive.
She has outscored Tallahassee by 8 points.
Ketchup no slouch this evening either. She's got 37 points of her own so far, and she's looking to add more with a whip and turn four. A nice hit and a spin move, and that's four more to the score of Tallahassee.
Brooklyn Hearts tried to jump in her way, but she got knocked down, and Ketchup kept rolling. Four points, as he said, on the board. That makes it 211 to 114. No Coast leading the team in orange. Under 11 minutes left in the contest. Womame, talk about Ketchup's points. Look at Womame's points, 47. She's three away from half a century, and she faces off on the line. We say faces off, they're really facing the same way. She shoulders off against Flash Gloria. As we mentioned, 118 points for Flash Gloria. Womame makes it through. Lead jammer Tallahassee once again.
She makes it look easy. And Flash Gloria now up against the three wall, but makes her way through. Not a whole lot of resistance there, able to just slip kind of right through. Low Mame on the inside of turn three and four, takes the inside lane and picks up 4 points.
Low Mame now with 51 points in the game after that last jam, and that does, of course, keep her as the top jammer for Tallahassee.
Tallahassee now sits at 118, No Coast 211. We've got about 9.5 minutes left in this bout. Slam Anderson on the jam line for No Coast. And Stonehur for Tallahassee.
Three wall of Tallahassee. It's enough to keep back Slam Anderson while Stonehur goes for it and picks up lead jammer. Tallahassee holding her arm as she comes out, her upper arm.
Looks like, yeah, that
must have caught an elbow.
Shoulder, yeah.
Got a noogie. But she knows that she has to use that arm, and that's what she does now. She muscles her way through for her initial scoring run, and it is a 5-point pass. Did we mention Slam Anderson is in the box now? So a power jam, Tallahassee, but she does call it off. It is going to be Ketchup jamming instead. Ketchup about to catch up to Low Mame. She's only 10 points behind her. She's got 41 points for Tallahassee.
Let's take a quick second to thank Iron Doll Clothing, custom uniforms for the modern roller derby girl and referee, lifting and separating since 2009, Iron Doll.
Ketchup trying to lift and separate this three wall in the front of the house by No Coast, and she is having a hard time doing it. She gets pushed back into the fracas. Kelly rip a nipple off, just grinding her out. I correct myself, that was actually champagne, a mistake that has been made by announcers for 5 years now. Ketchup finally makes it out the front of the pack. Lead jammer, Tallahassee. And Slam Anderson, the jammer for Noco, still in the box. Ketchup has an opportunity to put some more points on the board. We do still have 7.5 minutes. I mean, it's a tough mountain she's looking at, but.
Yeah, certainly would like to close that gap and make it look a little bit better on the scoreboard.
Yep, 5 more points is what she gets. She does take a hit out of the real Kelly rip a nipple off as she comes out, but she is able to put 5 more points on the board. 211 to 128, 7:07 left in the game. No Coast in black. Orange is the signature color of Tallahassee and their state's chief export. Can't back it up, but feel free to hit up Wikipedia and find out.
And then when you find out he's wrong, you can tell him at
#talk2WFTDA. That's right, on Twitter. Yeah, let us know.
If I were a betting man, which I'm not, I would bet on oranges.
I would bet on oranges, but at this rate, I'm starting to think it's roller derby teams. Flash Gloria, the lead jammer, en route, plunges into a big orange wall and takes down half of them, including herself. Scrambles back to her feet. Low Mame looking for the front. She makes it out now, but.
Little bob and weave action there.
Yeah, that was her initial non-scoring run, and somewhere in the melee, she did get passed up by Flash Gloria. So that's a 5-point lead, and Flash Gloria lets her get close and eat a couple more seconds before she calls it off. 5:55 on the clock, 216 to 128, No Coast over Tallahassee.
No Coast doing a very good job today, too, getting their skaters off the bench and on the jammer line a lot quicker. Just that extra added defense that they have pretty consistently throughout this bout.
Evo a speed, shoulders off against Stonehur, but it is Evo a speed who makes it through first. Lead jammer, No Coast. Stonehur hung up behind a serious three wall. All the heavy hitters, but she makes it through. Tell you what, that's got to be one of the most intimidating sights, is rolling up on a wall of defense made out of Kelly ripping nipple off champagne and thicker than a snicker. What are you going to do?
Yeah, that's intense. That is very intense. And we've got Low Main taking the jammer line for Tallahassee, going up against Slam Anderson jamming. We've got an official timeout, though, so we'll take this moment to thank our WFTDA.TV partners, Blood and Thunder Magazine, Derbyology, Derbalife, Derby for All, Derby Skins, Fast Girl Skates, Five Stride Skate Shop, Jammer Up, and Wicked Skatewear. Thank you all so much for your support of WFTDA.com.
There's a two-part sign here, and the fans in Section 21 having a hard time getting it right. It says, South Central does it like nobody does. And then if you're curious as to what they mean, there's actually another sign that says, and I'm not making it up, butt scratchers right below it. So hopefully that wasn't meant to be part of the same series. I believe we received word that the official timeout is due to somebody 7 minutes in the penalty box. And Double H, tell us who it is.
That is 4000 Great Wall of Gina. She is fouled out of the game.
Great Wall of Gina, done for the day.
Meanwhile, we've got both jammers out of the pack, approaching the pack on their scoring run, and Slam Anderson calls this one off. It's a wash. Score stands 220, No Coast, Tallahassee 128. We've got about 4 minutes left in this bout.
No Coast 220. It's going to be a tough thing to overcome, and of course, there's only 4 minutes left now, but Tallahassee did not stop playing for 1 second. They have acted like it was a tie game this entire time. But of course it wasn't, thanks to the expert jamming and defense of No Coast.
Flash Gloria out of the pack on the outside, and turn one quickly becomes the lead jammer in this one. Stone her. Jukes and jives her way out of the pack, and she is on her scoring run, but Flash Gloria picks up four.
And then she hangs back, watches Stone her, decides to wait till the last second to call it off. That's what she does.
Just in the nick of time, too. Almost had some allowed there. But
yeah, she would cut it a little close.
But I don't think it's going to matter that much if she allows a few at this point.
They would probably survive a few more points on the Tallahassee side.
Hey, everybody, check out the Bracket Bonanza sponsor, 2-in-1 Skate Shop. You can take 10% off your entire order at 2in1skateshop.com when you use the coupon code Bonanza during checkout. 2-in-1 Skate Shop, shock the competition.
Jamming next for No Coast, Eva Lespie. She's already put up 65 points in the game, and she's looking for more. Picks up lead jammer. Low Mame is who she's shouldering off against in this jam, but she makes it through first, puts 4 points on the board, and out. Our expert research team, by which I mean Double H, has reported back with the following news. The fourth biggest export in the state of Florida is greenhouse flowers. Number three would be sugarcane. Number two is tomatoes. And number one, oranges, of course. Who called it?
Good call.
Thank you.
And we are back into the action here.
It's one of the few predictions that have come true by anybody this weekend.
Stone Hur now, the lead jammer for Tallahassee.
And Slam Anderson caught up behind this defense. Oh, on the inside.
Ooh.
Slid through there untouched. Stone Hur, excellent work. 5 point pass. And looking for another one. She's not going to get this because Slam Anderson has made it out of the pack now, but she will get another 4 point pass. And shut it down. 9 unanswered points for Stone Hur.
Nice work.
No Coast 228, Tallahassee 137 is what it makes it.
And you should know that you can talk directly to thousands of Derby fans. Advertise on WFTDA.TV. Affordable packages are available for your business, boot camp, or tournament advertising. Visit WFTDA.com/sponsors/opportunities to learn more.
And, of course, we'd like to thank the following South Central Region Playoff sponsors and partners: Blood and Thunder Magazine, Bones Bearings, Bont Skates, Cruise Skate Shop, Derby for All, Derby Love, Derby Skins, Fast Girl Skates, and Five Stride. Low Mame, probably the final lead jammer of the game, picks it up directly, enters the back of the pack, knocked out by Thicker Than a Snicker, but she comes back in behind her, and this time ground out by Brooken Hearts. Puts 2 points on the board, 9 seconds left, and I got a feeling Tallahassee wants one more.
Yeah,
they
there
do.
There it is, timeout.
With 4 seconds left, they take it.
We've got a few more people to thank here. We'd like to thank these other WFTDA South Central Region Playoff partners: 5-on-5 Mag. You can find them 5on5mag.com. Printco, Sin City, Sisu Mouth Guards, Vanilla Skates, Viva Las Vegas, and Wicked Skatewear.
Puerto Rican Poison. Coach for Tallahassee talking to her huddle. South Central does it like nobody does. Say the fans from the Floridian Sisters of Tallahassee.
Don't forget, you can talk to us.
Madam President, this is for you. Talk to WFTDA and a much more clear, readable form. And that, and we appreciate it because we can't tell people enough that hashtag talk to WFTDA with the numeral 2 in the middle, not the word.
Yeah, we'd like to talk to you.
It's the best way.
Obviously, we like to talk for a living.
We like to hear from you.
We're talkers. That's what we do. Stonehurst going to be in this final jam for Tallahassee. Evil of Speed for No Coast. It looks like Stonehurst is out to a bit of an advantage here. Still got one blocker, and she clears the pack. She's the lead jammer, Tallahassee.
Bully McSkater followed her for a ways out the front of the packs. But she wasn't able to hold her back, and Stonehurst are going to put a 5-point pass on the board here at the end of the game. No more time on the period clock, but Stonehurst is going to take everything she can get. Stonehurst puts another pass up, calls off the jam. She only gets 3 for that one. She was bounced out, and the No Coast jammer had cleared the pack. The No Coast jammer actually able to sneak in for one more point to make it 229 to 148. No Coast over Tallahassee. And ladies and gentlemen, that wraps up day 2 of the Landlocked Lace Up right here in beautiful, if rapidly more chilly, Lincoln, Nebraska. It's been a wonderful tournament, and the No Coast hosts doing a great job in it. They're going to go on to play against Nashville in the 5th place game tomorrow, and they would love to have it.